After publishing a video on this GTX660, comparing Windows to Linux performance and indeed having some performance issues on Linux, I got some comments that might help improve things over on the Linux side. Today we're going to test some DXVK SARAC options to see if those might help improve things a bit. We're also going to upgrade the CPU from the original AMD A4-5300 to an A8-7600, which has more and faster cores. The A8-7600 also upgrades this system from FM2 to FM2+, which will change the PCIe bus from 2.0 to 3.0. Who knows where that might lead us? Let's find out together after the intro. Before I started, I figured I wanted to test things on a single SSD instead of two separate ones for Windows and Linux. So I copied all games to an external drive, shrank the Windows partition to a minimum, cloned the Windows installation to a bigger SSD, and installed EndeavorOS next to Windows. I was testing a Pico KVM unit while doing this, by the way. That's why you see this in a browser window. After installing everything, I created a new ext4 partition to fill the rest of the SSD with and mounted that on the /games on Linux. I copied all games to that partition and I swear I have captured that, but I can't find the footage anywhere, so you'll have to take my word for that. Back in Windows, I installed ext4 FSD, so I could mount that ext4 partition in Windows as well. This is where my Steam library will be, so games are mostly the same on both sides. I confirmed that performance on Windows was still the same by trying some games. Right, so back in Linux, we're now at the point we can try out some tweaks. Starting the game that performed worst of all, You Suck at Parking, I tried running that with the option DXVK All Cores is 1. Well, that didn't help. So I tried the asynchronous variant of Proton Serac. I tried the async draw call threshold setting, although I didn't really know how to set it correctly, so I started with a value of 1. Well, that was a mistake. The game didn't seem to be willing to run at all. So I tried a value of 10. Who knows? Well, that helped with the loading part, but performance still sucked more than my parking. At 5, the game struggled to load again. And at 8 it worked again, but now a tad better. Not really to write home about. And before someone says something about game mode seemingly being disabled, no, that wasn't the issue either. I couldn't get MXGP3 to run any better either. None of these options did a lot for Dredge as well. So no, I don't think there will be much we can do to make things better on the software side of things. So I decided to upgrade a CPU, see if that might change anything. But first, I updated the BIOS to make sure the new CPU has the biggest chance of getting accepted by this board. Of course, Windows had to reinstall almost all drivers, even the mouse and keyboard were completely alien to it. The BIOS update had also cleared the Linux bootloader from the EFI thingy, but that was easily fixed. Time to get that new CPU in. Here's the new heart for this system. Let's clear some of the crusty old paste from the cooler. Some fresh toothpaste. And the cooler back on top. Well, that was easy. Let's see if it boots. CPU or memory changed? Oh, really? Well, I'm glad it noticed. There we are. AMD A8-7600 with Radeon R7 graphics, which we're not gonna use today, but might be nice to check sometime. The Nvidia software indeed tells me we're running on a PCI 3.0 bus. Cool. On Windows, MSI Afterburner wouldn't show any GPU info though, and I couldn't figure out a way to fix that, so I just disabled the iGPU. Right, time for some new benchmarks. I will be using the same settings as last time. Starting again with Dredge, the game now runs way better on Linux, hitting over 120 FPS. I guess this one was very much limited by that A4 CPU. The result on Windows has improved a lot as well, but this time there isn't much of a difference between Windows and Linux. Doom 2016 is kinda boring, as the result is about the same as last time. Some 35 to 45 FPS on Linux and about the same on Windows. MXGP3, 1080p medium settings on Linux is again the same as last time, some 35 to 45 FPS. The native port using OpenGL performed even worse. On Windows we again see some 45 to 55 FPS. This game didn't benefit at all from the CPU upgrade. Asterix and Obelix XXL Romasterd already hit a 60 FPS ceiling on both operating systems last time. So yeah, same. Black Mesa at 1080p high settings got a slightly better frame rate on Linux this time, about 27 to 30 FPS in this scene, even a bit more than I got on Windows before. However, Windows has benefited from the CPU upgrade as well and now demolishes this result by outputting over 50 FPS. Ouch. Fun fact. The first try on Linux actually got me a way higher frame rate. This was before I disabled the iGPU though. Maybe this was being rendered on the internal R7 GPU? Let me know if you'd like me to test that one on its own. Use socket parking, again running 1080p and a very high preset, still sucked big time on Linux. Only when I moved it down to the normal preset, I got way better frame rates, as in about 15 times as high. That's a win compared to last time though, when I needed to set it to low to get a decent result. Still think it's weird that dropping from very high to high doesn't make a difference at all, and one step below suddenly gives us an insanely high frame rate. VRAM, maybe? I didn't even bother testing this one on Windows, as we already know from last time that this game ran great at a very high preset over there. Euro Truck Simulator 2 at 1080p and the high preset ran at the same 50-ish FPS on Proton Sarek. On Windows, the frame rate is still a tad better, with nearly 60 FPS most of the time. Borderlands 2, same settings as last time again, ran slightly better on Linux, using the native port with OpenGL. I got some 40 to 70 FPS last time, this time it's more like 40 to 90. Using the Windows version to Proton Sarek is still not the best idea, but better than last time. On Windows, frame rates seem to be similar to the Linux native port. Duck1979 asked me to try CS2. Sure, why not? The Linux native port, however, crashed on me before I could even start a practice session. I think this might have something to do with it using Vulkan and this card not supporting more recent Vulkan versions, so I switched to the Windows version using Proton Sarek. Performance was pretty horrible though. Only after switching to the lowest possible resolution of 960 by 540, I got a somewhat playable frame rate. On Windows, this game actually runs at a decent 50 to 60 FPS at 1080p. Damn. I guess this CPU upgrade only made things worse when comparing Windows to Linux performance on this GTX 660. It really isn't a great option for Linux gamers, I suppose. That's all I have for you today. Hopefully back with more positive news next time. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time.